In the last screencast, we went through the general concept of ratio control, which is a type of feed-forward control. Specifically, we measured the disturbance variable W1 and then adjusted W2, the manipulated variable, in order to hold the two mass flow rates at a fixed ratio. And based on the steady state values that we've been using in previous screencasts, we decided to keep them at a ratio of 3. But in order to actually calculate what the response would be, we need some transfer functions for our general expression. So previously we had derived a mass balance equation for the tank for the blending process. We have mass flow rates of two streams coming in and one stream leaving. And in this particular example, we'll just assume that we're filling the tank and we're just trying to keep the two inlet streams at a fixed ratio. That doesn't really change the analysis, but it just gives us one less term to consider in our example. Now we can take the Laplace transform of that time domain equation. And again, we can just assume that the tank is initially empty, which won't really change our analysis at all. So finally, we can get some transfer functions for this process by dividing through by S. This tank filling process is an integrating process, so that's why we have integrators, or 1 over S terms here, in our transfer functions. So here is our disturbance transfer function, GD. And here is our process transfer function, GP. In the last screencast, we derived a general expression for how the volume in the tank, V of S, would change under ratio control. So we had this general expression. And one thing to notice here is that there's only really one input to this process under feed-forward control. The only input now is W1 because W2 is calculated based on the measure W1. We have GD and GP for the process, but we still need GF. Typically, one might use a PI controller in order to get rid of steady state error, so that W2 can track at set point. But here, for simplicity of analysis and derivation, we'll consider a proportional controller with KP. So we can go ahead and plug in our expressions for the blending process. And then finally, we would need to pick a value for KP for our proportional gain in our control law. So we could try some different values and see how the performance works out. Let's go ahead here and just try a gain of 1,000 and see what happens. So we can pull out the 1 over S, the integrator term, from both values. And then we get 10 to the minus 3 plus 3. Now our KP and our 10 to the minus 3 are going to cancel there. And then we will just divide that by 1,001, 1 plus KP. And that multiplies W1 of S. So this actually gives us a value of 0.00398. And if you think about what is going on here, if we have a step change in W1, then that's going to give us a change in V, in the rate of change of V. If we actually were able to keep our 1-to-3 ratio, our flow rate going in would be 4 times and not 3.98 times the amount of W1. So we will have a little bit of steady state error here. If we increase the gain further, we could reduce that steady state error even further, although we might actually be better off using a PI controller to be able to reduce our controller gain and also get rid of any steady state error.